He'd slip away, he'd check the moon, take a little walks, and pretty soon they'd find him at the local auction barn. He'd stand and listen carefully, then pretty soon began to see how the auctioneer could talk so rapidly. He said, "Oh my, it's do or die, I've got to learn that auction cry, gotta make my mark and be an auctioneer. $25 bid, gimme who, gimme 25, a who, gimme 30, make it who, make it 30, who's a bid, oh, $30 bid. $35 bid, make it who, make it 35, 35, 30, make it who, give me 35, a who's a bid, or had a $35 bid." As time went on, he did his best, and all could see he didn't jest, he practiced calling bids both night and day. His pap would find him behind the barn, just working up an awful storm, trying to imitate the auctioneer. His pap said, "Son, we just can't stand to have a mediocre man selling things at auction using our good name. Well, I'll send you off to auction school, then you'll be nobody's fool, and you can take your place among the best. $35 a bid now, who give me 35 or 40, make it who, who make it 40, who's a bidder at a $40 bid? I got a $40 bid now, who give me 45, 45, 45, make it 45, who's a bidder for the $45 bid? And out from that boy who went to school, there grew a man who played it cool. He came back home a full-fledged auctioneer. And the folks would come from miles around just to hear him make that rhythmic sound. It filled their hearts such a happy cheer. His fame spread out from shore to shore, had all he could do and more, had to buy a plane to get around. And now he's the tops in all the land. Let's pause and give that man a hand, 'cause he's the best of all the auctioneers. I got a 45 bid now, who give me 40, man, a 50, make it 50, make it who, make it 50, who's a bid, a $55 bid. I got a 50 now, who make it 55, who make it 55, who make it 55, who's a bid, a $55 bid. Hey, well, all right, sir, what are you going to give for? Coming out of number 29 here, and what are you going to give for? And I got 125, make it 130, make it 130, make it 35, make it 30, 55.